I've got to do some manual labour today. I've done a load yesterday, but I've got to shift a 1-ton bag of sand from out the front of the drive back out into the garden, so I better get my finger out. Well, I've done all this on my own the other week, moved all these slabs from the front and brought them around the back. And I've also got two of these large sacks here, which were delivered at the front drive. And lucky enough, I've got one bag left over because that the actual sand was in that bag out the front. And I just wheelbarrowed it all around many, many times. And now I've got one more to do, as I say. So I'm going to bring the other bag around here now by wheelbarrowing it. So let's go out the front and make a start. Right, so let's shut the gates first of all. We don't want Barney running about, because I've got to have the side gate to the house open, you see, so get these closed. And I've got half a bag there still to do of sand. I've got all these slabs still to move around there, but for today, we got this bag here. Now, the other one was sitting here yesterday, and that took me an hour. Because don't forget, although it's a ton, you're putting it into a wheelbarrow, so you're moving a ton this end, and when you get the other end, you've got to unload it and put it back into another bag. So you're basically moving 2 tons of sand. So that took about an hour to do. So let me open the side gate. We're going to get the wheelbarrow, and I'll put you on a bit of time lapse for that. So I'll see you in a minute. Getting down there now, let's show you. Still loads to do. That was right at the top, as you remember, about up there somewhere. So we're getting there. It's 16 spadefuls in there. That's what I'm lifting at a time. And hold on, I can hear Sharon in the garden. What's she up to? Sun's very low in the sky at the moment, but let's get you around the other side. Hold on, baby. Stop. What are you up to?
Picking the leaves up.
Oh, so the grass.
And the grass is being cut.
Is it? So it has grown.
It has grown.
What are we in? The 8th of.
No, it's 11th. No, 12th.
12th of November. We've normally done. Well, we thought we'd done the first or the last cut. When was it? Start?
Last week.
Yeah, a week ago. But it looks like it has grown again.
Yeah, you can see, look.
But the thing is, you've got all the leaves on the floor and Sharon decided to come out here and do a little bit as well. That's the trouble with a big garden, Sharon, and having big trees overhanging. They drop all the leaves in the garden.
I must go. I'm on call.
Oh, here we go. Go on, off you go, baby. I'm going to carry on anyway. Oh, hopefully this is the last run now, and I should be able to lift this straight on there, hopefully. Maybe or maybe not, because this will be going in one piece, just standing around there, and then I've got that other half a bag to wheelbarrow, I won't be doing that today, into there and then straight into here. So if I can get this on there in one lift, I'll be happy. Get that around there like that. I don't know how much weight is in here, mind you, but oh, in you go. In you go. Here we go. That was a little bit heavy, but it's in there. It's not so much the heavy, it's just that you can't get hold of it properly because it moves about, you see. Right, that's it. Well, that was the main thing, because that was taking up a lot of space on the drive for getting cars in and out and moving about. I started this at just before 2 o'clock, and it's just gone 20 to 3. So yesterday it took me an hour. I've knocked about 15 minutes off my time. Hello? Last one, look. 15 minutes quicker, baby.
What'd you do, the slabs?
That's not getting done today, the slabs. What I've done is set myself out an hour a day, good solid physical exercise. One bag, two bags, and tomorrow I'll do the other half a bag and quite a bit of them slabs, I would imagine. So that's given me 3 good days exercise there. Saves me going on the old cross trainer, which I do half hour a night normally when I'm not doing any exercise. So, and that right, baby?
Oh yeah.
Do you do anything today? Are you doing anything else?
I've got to do the ironing.
Ironing's not exercise, baby. He keeps shapping Barney, doesn't he? Right, I'm going to get this round there, Sharon, and that's me done for the day, okay?
Okay.
That sky looks a bit grey, Sharon, doesn't it? Look. Look at that, look. Looks like it could rain. I think I've done that just in time. Look, look, I've done that, cleared that for you.
For me?
Well, I do everything I do for you, baby.
Oh, thanks. Let me kiss you for that. I've got a good husband, don't I?
Oh, I'm on the microphone. You're on my microphone under my jumper.
Sorry, people.
No, they wouldn't have heard nothing, Sharon. I think it would have been all right, but... So that's all I got left, and I moved them round the front originally.
No, I moved them round the front.
Eh?
I put them there.
Did you?
Yeah. You lifted them up and I brought them round, do you remember?
No. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Back.
Well, how about then?
No.
You take them back round, baby.
Oh,
eh?
It hurt my back.
Yeah. So they got to go round. How many is there? I can't remember.
Well, 80, I think there was.
75 to 80 there. But the reason why they come round here is because I was getting rid of them, but now obviously we're going to use them again, aren't we? You know, they're going to be laid under the new workshop or log cabin or an extension to the log cabin. I've got to cut these blackberry bushes back as well because they're encroaching on the drive as well.
Oh.
So I might get that done this season because they grow really, really quick. And to be honest with you, they're lovely blackberry bushes, but they grow absolutely everywhere. You can grow these anywhere. But we don't use blackberries, to be honest with you. We've used them once or twice this year, haven't we?
We've got them round the back though there as well.
And we've got them round the back as well, that's right. So we'll play that by ear. Right, let me get this wheelbarrow around. You follow me around, baby.
I'm just practicing.
Oh, aren't you, eh? And I'll have a nice cold drink in a minute.
Oh, what's this parcel?
Hey?
Parcel.
What is it? For me?
Nail varnishes.
Nail varnishes? I don't want to know about that. Right, let's carry on. Finish this last one off then. I can get inside and I might have a look in the workshop. Let's have a little look in there. I'll tell you what I want to do. I want to dig the graphics out for the side of the trot van. I won't put that on in today's video, but I might do that in a retro restore video because I want to start doing some work on that. But it'd be nice just to see some graphics on the side of it, wouldn't it? So I'll dig them out in a minute. Come on, baby. Yeah, as you know, we're doing all this sort of tinkering about stuff because it's lockdown still. Lockdown 2, as they call it now, or hashtag lockdown 2. Hey, I just made that up. Look, hashtag. I made that up, baby.
I like
That's a hashtag symbol.
I actually like that.
I like it. I don't know where it come from, Shell.
No.
I do things like that now and again. It's called spontaneous. Yeah?
Combustion.
No, not combustion, baby. Barney. Look, nothing. Look, Barney. Now, look, he turns round. Is he doing it on purpose? Barney. Barney.
He's only got ice and mummy.
Yeah, all right. All right, come on, let me wheelbarrow this round. Or do you want to wheelbarrow it round? No, do your back in. Just not empty. Well, do it. Go on in. Let's see you do. Let's see you do it, shall. Let's see if you can handle it. Is it too heavy? How does it feel?
Okay,
yeah, keep it balanced. Come on in. Now, it's all in the control. Look how you left that spade at the front, look.
You left that?
Yeah, but I would have straightened it, Sharon. You know? You're having a bit of trouble there, aren't you?
No, not really.
Come on, through you go. I'll follow you. Put it next to where, you see where I was putting a wheelbarrow? Put it next to that one there and I'll drag that off. Oh, I was trotting dog shit again, in second time. I thought you picked all the dog shit up, Sharon.
Hold
on, wait there.
When I'm cutting the grass.
As I'm following her, I've trod in bleating dog shit again, Sharon. Second.
That's dog poo.
Dog poo, Sharon, the second time. I thought you picked it all up.
Well, it says it's the same bit you've trod
in. No, it's not. It's a different bit.
Well, he does dog poo.
I know he does, Sharon, but it was old stuff. Trust me, I know. Right, I've got to drag this off. You just hold the wheelbarrow steady.
Do you want me to serve you thing?
Just stand still, Sharon. Don't argue.
I clip it.
No. Oh, good idea. Go on. No, not that way. I'm this way, aren't I?
Where are you thinking?
Stop now. Look, you've gone. The weight shifted. Look, it's got to go this way now, isn't it? What are you doing? What are you doing? Get that wheel.
Put that word on.
Yeah.
I tell you.
There would be a few words flying about now. I'm pulling that way. She's.
Oh, I'm laughing. She's. She's trying to have a go at me.
I can't have a go at you, Sheriff.
Oh, I'm going to have that camera with me wherever I go.
Go backwards, baby. Come on. I'm a about now. Unbelievable. Right. Yeah, Cheryl, give us a pull. Come on. Come on, that mess about now. I could lift it on my own, but why have a dog and bark yourself? Come on.
No, I'll not kill my back.
It's not your back. Oh, I lifted it into the wheelbarrow, Sharon.
Yeah, I've done it for you.
Come on, a bit more. On here, just not the ear. Ready? Lift, pull. I lifted that on my own, Cheryl.
No, you didn't. I lifted it as well.
Into the wheelbarrow. All you done was let it fall that way. Right, okay.
I can't help you anymore.
You will, baby.
You're having a go.
I'm not having a go. Right, okay.
Come on, honey,
let's go and salt. Oh, right. Sharon, I'll have a nice cold drink.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to have a little look in the polytunnel. And I want to dig the trotter stickers out because I might put them on in a butler.
Exactly
not in a butler's empire, in a retro restore video. Let's have a look in the polytunnel. Right. I'm looking for things to do. I know I've got the trotter van, but. I was going to have a little go at maybe something in here. Now, we got this web lawnmower here, which we could restore, I take it, and do up. Or I've got that little monkey bike down there, which is an old like a pocket bike sort of thing, not a trials bike. Let's show you a bit near. It's in very rough condition. I got it at auction for about, I don't know, I think it was 15 quid, I think I paid for it. It does run, or it did run the last time I started it, but obviously that was a long, long time ago and I don't even know, everything's seized up on it, but what I was going to do was strip it all down and it's going to need new forks, it's going to need a new set of body kit on it, it's going to need new this, that, the other, or whatever, but I know the engine did walk or did run, but you let me know in the comment section what you'd like me to try and do that next on Retro Restore, as well as the trotter van. Do you want me to try and have a go at restoring or at least resurrecting this a little bit? Or maybe we can start stripping down this web lawnmower. We did start doing some work on that. As you can see, I did powder coat all these parts. They're all blinking cleaned up and powder coated there, ready for Gary when he was going to do it. But the chances are I'm going to end up doing it. So there's the two things, the web lawnmower or the little pocket bike. See what one of them you'd like me to start as a second little project while I'm working on the trotter van. Okay, I've got all these stickers here. Now I've got old sets and new sets. Way when I first got the trotter van, I did buy some off of eBay and put all this stuff over there, baby. Look, get your purse out of the way, look. That was this first set, which is there. That you can see they're the older ones. So that's that lot. Oh, that's one I made up. I made them up on my cutter. It was just going to be for some wall art, I can't remember. But I actually done that one myself.
Are you going to buy a boot one? You're going to do it up?
What was I going to get?
You're going to put a mirror in the boot like people have them on their walls, don't you?
Yeah, but that weren't for that. That's for the side sticker.
Oh.
So I did do that myself on my vinyl cutter, the vinyl cutter I got now, which ain't too bad, but yeah, that was that one. And I got these ones off of Neil Huckle. There we go. I got these ones, which are supposed to be the nearest looking ones you can buy. Oh, that might be on the back door. That's the bit on the back door, sorry. So you've got that one for the back door. That's on the back door. I think that goes at an angle. And yeah, I think these are the back door ones. These three here. And these are the ones for the side, already spaced. So you just got to literally get these on the side. There's two of them, obviously, as you can see there. Whereas these ones, which I bought, first of all, a long time ago, you have to put them on yourself because the spaces ain't done, as you can see. And they're slightly different font. These fonts, which Neil Huckle recreated, was very, very similar to the originals. And these were the ones I actually copied when I done my own ones there, as you can probably see. They're very, very similar. That's the one I done on my own computer. So that's very similar to the font that I put on my Trotter's lawnmower anyway. So that was that, yeah. And I also made a couple of other little stickers there. So these are the sort of things I can still do, believe it or not. I've done a VW sticker, I've done a Batman sticker there, and also like a Mick Jagger tongue sort of thing. I can do these anytime, but I don't do these for a living or selling or whatever. So, I mean, please don't email me asking me to do one for you, because it takes a lot of time to set the stuff up just to make off one-off stickers. If I was doing something like that, I'd do a run of them, but I don't do that sort of stuff anyway. So, yeah, there's the Trotter Van sticker. So I might put them on in the next Retro Restore video. So I think we'll leave our video here today, baby. Little Butler's Empire, turn around, you've gone the wrong way. I say pull you this way, you go the other way. I was pulling you this way, just like when you're tipping a wheelbarrow, you tip that the other way. Spin round. Do a Wonder Woman spin round, baby, come on.
Say, does it make any difference?
No, it doesn't. So I'll have this nice cold drink which you prepared for me.
Oh, that noise.
And we'll see you in the next video. And don't forget, if you do like our channel, hit the what, Sharon? Down there. What is it?
My ding-a-ling.
The subscribe button,
oh,
baby.
Oh, is it? I thought it was the bell.
Well, there is a bell, but it's a subscribe button.
And share.
No, forget about the share. No one ever shares videos, Sharon. Not as far, not our level anyway. They might do if they're very popular videos, but so ring that little notification bell. Set your preferences to all. That way, you get notified every time we upload a video. And what is it?
I don't know.
Check out our Retro Restore channel. That way you'll see me probably installing these in the next Retro Restore video. Oh, someone's treading on Barney's tail. He's down there. And thanks very much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. And until then,
goodbye.
No, bye for now.
No, I say what I
want
to say.
Well, you say what you want, Shout. That's not what I say. I won't ask you to say it anymore then, will I?
I say bye. I always say bye au revoir. I never say bye for now.
You never say au revoir.
I've done.
When?
I've done it on the end of some of them.
I've never heard you say it. Go back and find me where she said au revoir. I bet you won't find one. You tell Porkis, baby. See you later, folks. Come on, let's go. Where are we going? Who knows? All the best.